चंडीगढ़ वॉज अ ट्रेलर, द मूवी फॉर पंजाब इज स्टिल अवेटेड. वेल विद दोज वर्ड्स आम आदमी पार्टी हैज कम आउट वेरी कॉन्फिडेंटली टू टॉक अबाउट हाउ देयर प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स इन द अपकमिंग पंजाब पोल्स आर एक्चुअली क्वाइट गुड. सो व्हाट हैपेंड? वेल द सिविक पोल रिजल्ट्स फॉर चंडीगढ़ केम आउट टुडे एंड आम आदमी पार्टी अ डेब्यूटेंट इन दिस इलेक्शन एक्चुअली परफॉर्म्ड वेरी वेल. दे went on to win quite a few number of seats over there, and this was about 14 seats as of this moment out of a total of over 30 as of this point. So Aam Aadmi Party got 14, Congress 8, BJP 12, and the Shiromani Akali Dal ended up with just one. Well, Aam Aadmi Party is saying the mood for Chandigarh is the mood for Punjab.
For Aam Aadmi Party, as election results for the Municipal Corporation of Chandigarh today, it was announced, and out of the 35 seats, Aam Aadmi Party bagged maximum of 14 seats. So for the first time, it was Aam Aadmi Party was in the electoral fray in Chandigarh. We saw Arvind Kejriwal came here, he campaigned. Raghav Chadha in the Punjab unit of Aam Aadmi Party was very active in the campaigning. As far as Chandigarh's municipal corporation campaign was is concerned, and what worked for Aam Aadmi Party in these polls were that the announcements made, the poll promises which were done by Arvind Kejriwal when he held a public rally here in Chandigarh, saying that the entire Delhi model of governance will be implemented in Chandigarh, saying that the corporation will be corruption free, the deliveries of all the services will be based on home delivery system as you have it in Delhi. Other than that, it also, the Aam Aadmi Party is certainly trying to project this victory as a referendum or the mood of the voters in Punjab. But will it go Aam Aadmi Party way in Punjab or not? That has to be seen. A couple of months later, Punjab will see, or Punjab goes to polls. Lot of realignments are working in Punjab as well. Amrinder Singh joining with BJP. A new alliance is coming up in Punjab. But here, as of now, a big victory for Aam Aadmi Party, though they fell short of, you can say, the maximum or halfway mark in the Municipal Corporation of Chandigarh. But for the first time, getting into Chandigarh, winning maximum seats out of 35, 14 seats have been backed by Aam Aadmi Party. Big setback for the BJP, which last time won 20 of the 26 seats. Now these seats or wards have been increased to 35 for this poll in 2021. And out of the 35 seats, Aam Aadmi Party bagging 14, BJP following them with 12. In a short while, Manish Sisodia, the Deputy CM from Delhi, is arriving here, and he will be addressing a press briefing on how this polls is a sort of mood of voter poll for Punjab, which Aam Aadmi Party is certainly trying to project ahead of polls. This result is certainly going to boost their confidence, will certainly going to give them more energy ahead of Punjab polls. In Chandigarh, Mohammed Ghazali for NDTV.
All right, so fascinating results over there, especially encouraging for the Aam Aadmi Party. But remember, they're still four short of that magic figure of 18 to actually get to have their own mayor elected as Chandigarh. But for a debutant party to perform this way is being seen quite encouragingly. But how are the rest of the political opponents actually viewing this? Let's break it open to our panel now. Joining us is Mahesh Inder Greval, spokesperson of the SAD, former cabinet minister in the Punjab government as well. We've got Majinder Singh Sirsa, now of the BJP, joining us on this discussion. Also, Daniel Francis, political analyst, supports the Congress, is with us. We've got Ehbab Singh Greval. He's a spokesperson for Aam Aadmi Party in Punjab. And also Charan Singh Sapra joins us on the phone line. So interesting, we've got all the players on the panel. So I want to begin by giving the first word to actually the BJP. Mr. Sirsa, interesting results, won't you say? And while Aam Aadmi Party, there is dhol, nagara, full Punjabi style celebration happening there for them, they seem to believe this is a mood that will reflect all across Punjab. And the victory of Aam Aadmi Party seems to be eating out on the votes that BJP actually held. If you look at the last election, as Ghazali was also pointing out, the last civic polls that happened in Chandigarh, BJP had a sweeping majority, 20 out of 26. And now, not even half.
Yes, Sonal, definitely it's a big setback for BJP also. Reason being, we got almost half number of seats there. But at the same time, as we all are aware, what happened here in Delhi and what happened there in Punjab in 2014 and thereafter in 2017, thereafter in 2019. Definitely, Aam Aadmi Party as being of all hopes to the people across the nation. And by the in 2014, they got 4 seats in Lok Sabha. Thereafter, they just won 1 seat, that to Bhagwant Mann. And that the same happened in 2017 also. They got almost 2 dozen elected. They got 2 dozen MLS elected from Punjab. And thereafter, in the civic polls, they even not got 10 councillors elected from the whole of Punjab. So this in the marketing, there is no comparison of Arvind Kejriwal. In Vidhan Sabha also, I've raised this, ki ek aisa aadmi hai jo ganje ko kanki bech sakta hai. That are definitely Arvind Kejriwal and Arvind Kejriwal only. But at the same time...
Isn't that the phrase, Mr. Sirsa, that actually Rahul Gandhi had used for the Prime Minister? If I remember correctly,
I'm not
in the
sure.
Parliament,
I'm
the
not
same
sure.
phrase?
I'm not sure about
but
that.
If you look
I'm
at the percentages, and I hope you can look at the screen where we're actually flashing it, the entire percentage of seats won for the Aam Aadmi Party this year is actually all of it eating up into the BJP's vote. Aam Aadmi Party up by around 40%, BJP down by almost 43%. So far we'd always heard the BJP saying that Aam Aadmi Party actually eats into the Congress vote bank. It has actually for the first time eaten into the BJP vote bank.
Yes, definitely, Sonal, because BJP was a ruling party in Chandigarh from last 2 terms, and definitely the councillors must have a anti-incumbency vote also. But as I said, you, it's a known fact that Arvind Kejriwal, once ever where he goes, he can convince the people with his conviction of words, which he choose very wisely, no doubt. I always say that Arvind Kejriwal is the one person who can sell anything and anywhere. I in fact, in Vidhan Sabha, when he was sitting across to me, I pointed out this. At that point of time, he was opening one university, and university was nowhere, neither there was a land, neither there was a building, but he says, world-class university banne ja rahi hai, duniya ki sabse badi banni, aur opening kar rahe hain. But so anyways, to let it be a part of that.
Well,
but
all political parties, at the same time, Mr. Sirsa, to
yeah,
be
definitely, Sona,
fair, but, talk but, about that. But, I mean, we can just have the same story said against the BJP
like
when it comes to
is,
UP. So, you know, I'm not sure how that pans out, but I did hear you say as a first line that this is indeed a disappointment for the BJP, and they have some thinking to do on how their vote base is actually shifting to the Aam Aadmi Party, which is a new trend. I don't think we've seen that anywhere across any state. Talking about that, let me quickly check if I have the Aam Aadmi Party spokesperson back with us. All right, we'll just wait for Mr. Grewal's line to come to us. Let me go to Daniel Francis in the meanwhile. How are you reading these results, Daniel? And I just want to start by understanding, is Chandigarh really a representation of this beautiful state of Punjab? I mean, 5 different forms and different regions. How much of it is really a representation when it comes to Chandigarh?
I don't think Chandigarh truly represents Punjab or truly represents Haryana. Chandigarh has its own character. It's a capital that is shared by these both states. It's a very small city, and you know, the Aam Aadmi Party definitely made this election a triangular election. It has been persistently there. As we remember, it had fielded Gulpanag in 2014. And it did pretty well. Aam Aadmi Party is seen as an urban party, and you know, closer to Delhi, it has resonance in Chandigarh. And this is not just you know, a rejection of BJP, but also a threat to the Congress in a way, because imagine the vote share that BJP has gone down. Congress could have capitalized on that vote share if Aam Aadmi Party was not in the contest. So, but I really feel that they will use this election result to portray that the mood of this can help them to create a mood in Punjab. Well, I am having the, but my analysis makes me realize that this will have a very limited effect on Punjab, and because if you see in Punjab, the Aam Aadmi Party situation is very different. Their MLAs are actually abandoning them to join the Congress. And
well, I'm not sure how exactly that is happening, but let me bring in a word from the Aam Aadmi Party spokesperson. Mr. Grewal is with us. Firstly, congratulations, a fabulous debut in Chandigarh. But really, the question is, Chandigarh is a very urban center. How much of it is actually going to be reflected in the hinterlands of Punjab, where the maximum chunk of votes are?
Well, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Actually, the thing... Hello?
Go ahead, sir. We can hear you.
Hello. Yes, thank you very much. I don't agree with Mr. Francis in the sense that Chandigarh is basically an extension of Punjab and Haryana, and it sets the mood for the polls in for the coming polls in Punjab.
Hmm.
The thing here is that we always knew that this was going to happen. We thank the people of Chandigarh for giving us a chance. We are a new party, and they have shown that they are willing to take steps for on issue-based politics rather than politics of polarization.
Hmm.
And hopefully, we are very hopeful that Punjab will, this has set the tone, and Punjab will basically show the way to the rest of the country as well.
Right.
And
Mr. Grewal, you were saying that it sets the mood. But you know, I was there covering elections last time around for Punjab, and that time also the mood seemed to be very in favor of Aam Aadmi Party. But the results came out to be very different.
Exactly.
And in the end, it was figured out later internally by the Aam Aadmi Party also that people did not end up coming back to the booths. So how is that problem being sorted now?
I'll just get back to that. Well, last time around, unfortunately, there was a bomb blast and there was scaremongering. They were able to somehow create a situation wherein they scared the people into believing that the whole situation in Punjab was very volatile and things are going to take a turn for the worst. But this time around, people have seen through that trap. People have seen through that. If you remember, there was a bomb blast 48 hours before the elections. And then there was targeted killings. They tried it this time, but I think people are smarter now. And even it's not as if they are not trying right now. They are doing it. Politics of polarization is at work right now as well. But this time around, the people of Punjab are very sure that they are going to go for issue-based politics rather than on issues which are very mundane and which crop up just about, say, 6 months before the election.
All right. I'm not sure that really answers my question, because Aam Aadmi Party also was last time very quick in celebrating. I remember outside Arvind Kejriwal's house, there were big celebrations planned already. And when the numbers came, it really stumped everyone. So we wait to see.
Yeah.
Punjab voters are very secretive till the very end. So we wait to see actually what happens in this one. But let me go to Akali Dal next. Mahesh Inder Grewal is with us. So one seat. Now, Aam Aadmi and the SAD, beg your pardon, is also in alliance with Captain Amrinder Singh. I just want to know, was this civic poll actually fought with an alliance, or this was SAD on its own?
No, it was SAD alone. And in even last election, we had only one seat in Chandigarh, and you have seen, we have almost the same vote percentage. Now, I tell you one thing very clear. Let the Aam Aadmi Party feel happy with this result. They should also know that in Delhi parliament election, Modi got all the 7 seats. And in assembly, they got the government. And in the Delhi, they had a government, but they lost all the 3 municipal corporations after formation of government. So every poll and every different area has a different approach of the voters. And it will have no reflection. You should be knowing it that in 2014, they got 4 parliament seats. And there was no bomb blast in 2019, and they got only 1. And in 2019, their number of assembly segments, which they won, was only 7, when they got 20 in 2017. So coming down 13. So it is just in living fool's paradise. Actually, the hard reality is that it was a BJP. See, had it been that popular, yes, they have registered their entry, but people were wise enough not to give them majority to spoil the beauty of Chandigarh. So, second thing is, they should also know it very clearly, Chandigarh is a UT. All the funds are piped out to Chandigarh by the government of India.
Okay.
And the corporation of its own has no income. Hmm. What to say of income running the Chandigarh? Hmm. It's only all the center grant. They made the announcements, but implementation depends on the attitude of the government of India. What they do for them. So I think let them be happy for some time.
All right, let them be happy and they're living in fool's paradise is what the SAD is saying. Gentlemen, I'm so sorry. That's all the time we have on the show.